What's up guys, it's Tom here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool news video. And in this video we will talk about a lot of different topics, namely we will talk about Philippe Coutinho and his loan deal is now official to Bayern Munich and how Liverpool will benefit financially from that deal. Also what kind of Premier League record Sadio Mane set and what Sarri told another former Liverpool player Emre Can at Juventus. So this has to be a big warning sign and a big reminder to everybody who wants to leave Liverpool that the grass isn't always greener. Look at Coutinho, look at Emre Can. Coutinho had a disastrous season at Barcelona and he was loaned out to Bayern Munich. And the way that Coutinho and Bayern talked in his first press conference suggests to me that they are looking at a long-term transfer here, a long-term partnership. So it looks like Bayern might activate Coutinho's buyout option that they have at the end of the loan spell. But of course Coutinho has to do well in the Bundesliga, but I think the Bundesliga is a little bit worse than the Premier League and the La Liga, so I think Coutinho will shine if Bayern can find a position in the team for Coutinho where he can excel. Just don't make him defend like Valverde did, because that's not what Coutinho's game is. And also, apparently Sarri told Emre Can to find a new club at Juventus. He has to leave because at the moment Juventus have so many good midfielders. They signed Aaron Ramsey from Arsenal on a free transfer, and Maurizio Sarri, apparently according to the Liverpool Echo, is not considering Emre Can a viable option for his midfield. How the tables have turned. Emre Can left Liverpool to go to a supposedly bigger club to win trophies, and yes, he won the Serie A, but Juventus win the Serie A anyway, with or without Emre Can. And now Emre Can probably has to take a step down. I would be very surprised if a team like Bayern Munich or Barcelona or Real Madrid came in for him. Maybe Bayern Munich, he used to play for Bayern a little bit when he was a youngster. And of course, Liverpool fans have been reacting on social media. And actually, I loved this comment by one Liverpool fan. Just like Coutinho, Emre Can is another player that thought he deserved to be playing at a higher level. I'm sure he enjoyed watching us become European champions and win the Champions League. Oh my goodness, I love these snarky comments on Twitter. They are just brilliant. Another player who thought he could do better than Liverpool. Well, what now, Emre? It's just brilliant. Another Liverpool fan commented, Sarri doesn't want Emre Can at Juventus. Coutinho not needed at Barcelona. I'm loving it. Oh, this is brilliant. And yes, we have to be honest. I think this shows that staying at Liverpool is really special. And Jurgen Klopp himself said that it's a special place. And yes, we might not win as many trophies as Barcelona or Juventus, but the connection with the fans, with the manager, the players among each other, it's a really special place. And at Liverpool you can become a hero if you are part of the starting 11. You will get worshipped from the Liverpool fans. But at Juventus, at Barcelona, at Bayern Munich, even Coutinho is just another player. At Bayern Munich, Coutinho is not the biggest superstar, he is not like the biggest player, the most liked player. That's Lewandowski, that's Thomas Müller. The Germans, of course, they respect Coutinho and I think they will have a lot of admiration for him. But it will not be like Coutinho was at Liverpool, where he was the main man, the main guy. Everybody looked to Coutinho, everybody looked up to him. And Coutinho admits that the Barcelona transfer didn't work out the way he had hoped after he completed his loan move. And actually, Barcelona confirmed that Coutinho asked for a transfer as early as May. So as soon as the season finished with Barcelona, Coutinho asked for a transfer. So, and there are conflicting reports on how much Barcelona are getting as a loan fee. Some say it's £8 million, some say it's £15 million. Anyway, whatever Bayern Munich pay as a loan fee to Barcelona, that is going straight to Liverpool, because according to the Sport Spanish newspaper, Liverpool will receive the entire loan fee that Barcelona are getting, because Barcelona are yet to pay Coutinho's £142 million transfer fee in full. And in hindsight, you could say that Liverpool absolutely robbed and rinsed Barcelona, because there is no way Coutinho is worth anywhere near that £142 million. I mean, I will be surprised if Bayern Munich pay the €120 million asking price or buyout price that Barcelona set for Coutinho. Maybe at the end of the loan spell they will try to negotiate a lower transfer fee, or the B scenario is that Coutinho goes back to Barcelona after having a good season at Bayern Munich, and then he will be sold to another club, maybe for £70-80 million. But I think the ship has sailed for Coutinho to come back to Liverpool. Jurgen Klopp himself confirmed that Liverpool got offered the chance to sign Coutinho on loan, but Jurgen Klopp decided against it. And the reasons for that are probably very complicated, but the main points are that the way Coutinho left Liverpool and the way Coutinho treated the Liverpool fans, the fellow Liverpool teammates, and Jurgen Klopp was pretty horrendous, pretty disrespectful as well. And Jurgen Klopp is a man of discipline, and he can't tolerate that. And who knows, if Coutinho comes back to Liverpool, there is no guarantee that he wouldn't be a disruptive force. Because remember that this Liverpool side is a totally different, totally changed Liverpool side to the Liverpool side that Coutinho actually left. And I'm not sure if Coutinho would fit in perfectly into this Liverpool side. Of course, we would find a position for him, but he won't be the main player. He won't get the same treatment that he was getting previously at Liverpool, because previously everybody was playing around Coutinho, everything revolved around him. We were passing the ball to him always, and sometimes even it kept Liverpool a little bit down, kept Liverpool back, because Coutinho sometimes took shots from 30 yards which weren't realistic, which weren't really shots that he should have taken. And you could see that without Coutinho, Liverpool actually, as a collective, as a team, grew into this world-class powerhouse side, which is now one of the best five European teams. Yes, Coutinho would make us better, but Jurgen Klopp is not only taking into account what he can do on the pitch, but also off the pitch. And I think off the pitch, the way Coutinho left, it just left a bitter taste in the mouth of Jurgen Klopp, the players, and the Liverpool fans especially. And Coutinho told this reporters at his Bayern Munich presentation: "Concerning Barcelona, things didn't work out the way we wanted, but that's the past. This is a new club, a big club, an important club. I hope I will be here for a long time and win lots of titles. Within those years, I did have great experiences. I learned a lot, won a lot with Barcelona, and then we had the Copa America, which I won with Brazil, and that was really important. Now I have a chance at a new club, a big club. I didn't have any doubts when Hasan Salihamidžić, the Bayern sporting director, called me. He really wanted me to come here. So they flew to Barcelona, we met, they showed me the project, and that's why I really want to thank them, because from the first second it was clear how they see me. That was important for me to see." And yes, Bayern Munich see Coutinho as a really, really big player, really a superstar. And they want to build the team around Coutinho a little bit, and they needed a winger who can score goals, because they lost both Robben and Ribery in one transfer window. And yes, they have Gnabry, yes, they have Kingsley Coman, but they can get injured, they can get tired, and I think they really needed another big player. This just almost guarantees that Bayern Munich will win the Bundesliga this season, and it will be interesting what Coutinho and Bayern can do in the Champions League, because of course the big target for every season for Bayern is the Champions League, and they haven't won the Champions League in a long, long time. But I just really hope that Liverpool meet Bayern Munich again in the Champions League, because that would be just lovely to knock Coutinho out in the second season in a row after knocking out Barcelona with Coutinho in the team. Imagine the scenes if Liverpool knock out Bayern Munich again with Coutinho in the team. Oh, that would be just so, so sweet. But here, of course, I'm just dreaming. Coutinho also said, "For me, this move means a new challenge in a new country with one of the best clubs in Europe. I'm very much looking forward to that. Like FC Bayern, I have big ambitions and I'm convinced that I can achieve them together with my new teammates." And I think Hasan Salihamidžić, the sporting director, also made it clear what a big player Coutinho is for Bayern Munich. Philip made it very clear to us during the negotiations in Barcelona that he absolutely wanted to move to FC Bayern. He's a world-class player with great ability who we can deploy in a number of positions in our forward line. So FC Bayern squad has gained even more quality. Coutinho will help us achieve the ambitious targets we have set for this season. I'm not sure if Bayern will win the Champions League now, but that they are stronger now with Coutinho, definitely. And they also signed even Perisic on loan and a young talented player as well. So it's going to be very interesting. And according to the Evening Standard's David Lynch, he's a journalist and he's well connected with Liverpool. And he said that Liverpool will miss out only on 4.5 million because of Coutinho's transfer or loan's transfer to Germany. Because, you know, Liverpool were guaranteed to receive £111 million base fee, and the rest is made up of realistic add-ons and realistic bonuses. And now, instead of 144 million, we will probably get about 140 million, which is still an incredible deal. And I'm just happy that we sold Coutinho, because from that money we bought Van Dijk, we bought Alisson, we bought the likes of Naby Keita and other players, Shaqiri as well. And Liverpool are definitely much stronger without Coutinho. And Sadio Mane has set another Premier League record by scoring against Southampton. Sadio Mane has a goal on his first start of a Premier League season in each of the past four consecutive years. The last player to do the same was Mark Viduka between 2005 and 2002 for Leeds United. So Mane's strike was his third goal after following his two goals against Chelsea, which is all the more impressive considering that he had like no preseason and just a little bit more than 2 weeks holiday. And he started the season brilliantly, on fire. And after scoring 26 goals in all competitions last season and winning the Premier League Golden Boot alongside Mohamed Salah and Aubameyang, I really hope that Sadio Mane can keep scoring goals, and hopefully he can even better that tally and maybe score 30 goals this season. Diogo Jota, the Wolves striker, who is Portuguese and who had a great season last season in the Premier League, actually aimed a slight dig at Manchester United before the Man United game. And by the way, what a great game it was. Wolves drew 1-1 after Pogba missed the penalty, and Man United were the better team in the first half, but Wolves were the better team in the second half. So it was kind of similar to the Chelsea-Leicester game. Pogba missing the penalty was a very, very controversial thing. And because normally Marcus Rashford takes the penalties at Man United, and Marcus Rashford never missed a penalty in his professional career, and even Pogba missed four penalties in the last 12 months. Pogba has just a 64% conversion rate from the penalty area, and Rashford has a 100% conversion rate. And it's weird that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer doesn't have a designated penalty taker. He has Pogba and Rashford, and they can argue with each other every game to figure out who scores or who takes the penalties. And this is what Jota said about Man United and about Liverpool as well. "Of course, Man United will always be a great team, but when Manchester City and Liverpool are winning titles, they have more fans supporting them in Portugal. It has to do with the moment, and we have to be honest and say that Liverpool is having a better moment right now than Man United. Everyone likes winners, and when the younger fans look at the other countries, they like to see a team that is winning, like Man City and Liverpool." And I'm sure that Jota was trying to like rattle the cage of Man United, if you like. I don't think it's a good tactic against any team. This is just adding fuel to the fire to the Man United players, and I'm sure when they read this interview, they were just more fired up to beat Wolverhampton. I think a better tactic is to just praise them and say that they are a very good team, and that will make maybe the players overconfident. But yeah, it's difficult to figure out what the best solution is in giving an interview like this. But at least he's honest, and I admire that. Also, Sadio Mane apologized to Southampton for scoring against his former club. This is what he said: "I'm sorry it is against my old team, and I'm sorry that I have to score, but I'm wearing a Liverpool shirt now. Southampton was a very, very good step for me, and I have big respect for this club. It is an amazing place. I learned a lot here, and they are very nice people, but it is part of football, and you have to deal with it. What a game. It was not an easy game, but you have to expect a tough game like this at this stage of the season. After playing 120 minutes on Wednesday, it was not easy, and we know it will be difficult. It was not easy, and it took us a little bit of time to get going, but we got the 3 points, and I think we deserved it. Once we scored the first goal, it was easier for us." Brilliant interview by Mane, who is still my favorite Liverpool player. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. See you later, guys. Goodbye.